Wet your hands with water. Apply soap, rub your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub. And then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, who is the most merciful and most gracious. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? Hopefully, you all will be fine. Well, first of all, I would like to say welcome you all in my social studies and Saudi history class. This is week number 11 and lecture number 2. As you know, my name is Mrs. Sadaf Amreen. Before going to start, here are some general instructions. So dear students, listen carefully. Dear students, first of all, you have to mark your attendance. Secondly, keep ready your book, notebook, pencil, eraser, sharpener to note down the answers of the questions. And if you have any question, you can ask in the WhatsApp group. Hope the instructions are clear to follow. Lesson number 16, our country, will be continued today. Okay, so we will study more about of this lesson by doing some exercises. Okay, and so what are the contents of today's lecture? First, I'll give you a preview about the lesson, our country, that we have studied in our previous lecture. And after preview, we will do exercise A, page number 77 on book. Activity, you have to do this activity as a homework. Paste a picture of a Qaid-e-Azam in copy. And Saudi history, there is a question. Question number 11, you have to note down. Question number 11, that is fill in the blank. So you have to note down in your notebook. Okay, so you should keep ready your book for social studies work, and you should keep ready your notebook of Saudi history, or if you have the same notebook of social study and Saudi history, so you should keep ready your social study notebook. Okay, so get ready for that. So first, there is a preview. Okay, I'll give you a preview about the lesson that we have studied in our previous lecture. So listen carefully. Yes, we were studying lesson number 16, our country. And what is the name of our country? Pakistan. Yes, we are Pakistanis. Our nationality is Pakistani. So we know many things about our country, but some things we will study in this lesson also. So what we have studied already, first I will revise it, and then I will teach you the today's work, that is an exercise of exercise A of this lesson. So let's start. In our previous lecture, I have told you about the provinces of Pakistan. You know, we have four provinces of Pakistan. So what are four provinces? Punjab, Sindh, Balochistan, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Azad Kashmir. Here is a map of Pakistan. You can see the location of all these provinces in the map. Where is located Balochistan, where is Sindh, where is Punjab, where is Kashmir. So you can see in the map. And as I have already told you about the capital of these all provinces, like Lahore. Lahore is the capital of Punjab, Karachi is the capital of Sindh, Quetta is the capital of Balochistan, Peshawar is the capital of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, KPK, and Azad Kashmir is a separate state. Okay, so these are the provinces of Pakistan. Okay, Pakistani currency and historical places. Okay, you can see here the Pakistani currency, like 50 rupees, 100 rupees, 1000 rupees, 500 rupees, 5000 rupees, and a coin. You can see here our currency, our Pakistani currency is called rupee. ठीक है, हमारी पाकिस्तानी करेंसी जो है उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं, रुपी. एंड इन आवर सऊदी अरेबिया द करेंसी ऑफ सऊदी अरेबिया इज कॉल्ड रियाल. ओके, सो रियाल ऑफ इज द सऊदी अरेबिया, सऊदी करेंसी, सऊदी अरेबिया करेंसी, एंड रुपी इज आवर पाकिस्तानी करेंसी. नाउ यू कैन सी हियर सम हिस्टोरिकल प्लेसेस like K2, Faisal Mosque, Badshahi Mosque, and the residency of our great leader Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Okay, one thing I want to tell you about the K2. K2 is the highest mountain in our Pakistan, and you know this is the second highest peak in the world. Okay, so K2 is the second highest mountain peak in the world. Okay, dear students, and all other historical places are very much beautiful. Everyone must visit those places. Okay, so now what's more in our country? Let's see. Look at here. Very beautiful pictures. You know our country is very beautiful. Pakistan is very beautiful country. Allah blessed it with different types of things, and especially if we talk about the beauty, this is the beauteousest, you can say, yeah, most beautiful country among in the whole world. Okay, so Pakistan is most beautiful country in the world. You can see here the pictures. Pakistan is very beautiful country. Now here are some major cities of Pakistan, like Karachi, Lahore, Faisalabad. You can see in our cities everything is there, like roads, huge buildings, traffic, small towns, and big cities, small cities. So Pakistan have all type of communities. Some are living in big cities, some are living in small cities. So Karachi, Lahore, Faisalabad are the main cities of our country, Pakistan. Now in down picture you can see the universities of Pakistan. There are many universities in our country. You can see here some pictures of the universities of Pakistan. Deserts in our country, there are four deserts also. Okay, the Haran Desert, the Thal, and the Cholestan, and the Thar. These are the four deserts in our country. You know what is desert? Deserts are the sandy area of the land. So in our country there are four deserts: the Haran Desert, the Thal, the Cholestan and the Thar. Look at here, we have done reading and explanation in our previous lecture. I just quickly go through again. So lesson number 16, our country Pakistan is a beautiful country. There are mountains, valleys, hills, plains, rivers and lakes in Pakistan. We have thick forests and wide open deserts. There are many cities and towns, old and new. Over the years, the people of Pakistan have built many useful places. Okay, as I told you, as I show you some pictures of cities, towns, valleys, mountains, plains, deserts. So all these things are there in our country. Okay, you can see here the picture of K2. As I told you, K2 is the highest mountain in Pakistan. And sand dunes are the hills of sands. Okay, so along the Makran coast, you know, the land that is near the sea. Okay, so this is the place of Makran coast of Balochistan. CPAC of Balochistan, you can see, and this is a big plan of infrastructure construction in our country, and an aerial photo of Karachi. When you sit in, if you take a photo from the aircraft, that photo is called an aerial photo. Okay, so this is an aerial photo of Karachi. There are buildings, roads and parks, there are universities, factories and airports, and there are canals, bridges, harbors and dams. So all these things are there in our country: buildings, roads, parks, universities, factories, airports, harbors, you know, the seaports are called harbors, bridges, canals, everything. Dams are there in our country. So this country is our home. We must look after it and keep it looking clean and beautiful. Okay, our country is very beautiful and we should take care of it, and we should keep clean it and looking keep clean and beautiful. Okay, so here you can see the pictures of Gwadar. Is an important coast of Pakistan. Okay, the Gwadar is an important coast, you know, the land near the sea. Okay, so Gwadar is the land that is near the sea, and that land is very much important. So Shah Faisal Mosque is situated in Islamabad, and Clifton Beach, Karachi. This is the Clifton Beach, Karachi. And the Dilawar Fort in Cholestan Desert. This is the Dilawar Fort in Cholestan Desert. Okay, dear students, what the main things I have revised all, and now we will do the exercise A. Okay, so keep ready your book, pencil, eraser, and sharpener. Okay. Work page, exercise A, page number 77, and this work you have to do on the book. Okay, so exercise A, write the correct word under each of the following. ठीक है, जो भी picture आप देख रहे हैं उस picture के नीचे उसका जो है वो name लिखना है. ठीक है, so here are some names of the places like bridge, fort, dam, factory, mosque and monument. Your teacher will tell you more about these man-made things. Okay, so first of all we have to write the names of the these pictures like dam. Okay, the first picture is a dam, then Faisal Mosque hai, so we will write here mosque, and after that there is a factory, you will write factory, and fort. Okay, and bridges, bridge, and monument. Okay, you know fort. Do you know fort were constructed by the king, okay, to show or to influence the people, to show their wealth, their power and glory of a king, okay. So that reason they built fort, okay. So king used to build fort to show their power, to show their wealth, and to show the, you can say that they want to influence the people, okay. They want to impress the people, so they want to show off their wealth. They want to show off their wealth, so that's why they make the fort, okay. They build the fort, okay. So fort were constructed by the kings of different kings and different era, okay. What is dam? Actually, dam is built to hold water back, okay, and after that you can use that water to make the electricity and other different uses. You can use that water in different way, okay. So the dam is built to hold the water back, okay. What is factory? Factory is actually a manufacturing plant, okay. Use complex machinery to produce different things, goods for us. So it is a manufacturing plant, or you can say a production plant, okay, in which different types of complex machinery is used to produce different kinds of items, okay, or different kinds of products. And what is bridge? Bridge, you can see here is a bridge, okay. People use bridge to cross the road, or people use bridge to cross the river, okay. So these type of bridges are built to cross sometime valley, or sometime road, or sometime river, without closing the way, okay. So this is bridge. And what is monument? Monument is a statue or a building, okay, for rememberable person or events, okay, like in Qaid-e Azam, okay. So Qaid-e Azam is a rememberable person, so we built a monument of Qaid-e Azam in Karachi, okay. So in Urdu you can say ye yaadgar hai, Qaid-e Azam ki yaad mein, Qaid-e Azam ki nishani ke taur pe unki yaad mein ek building banayi gayi, theek hai. Is tarah ki jo buildings hoti hain unko kehte hain monuments, okay. Hope you have noted down dam, mosque, factory, fort, bridge and monument. Activity: paste a picture of a Qaid-e Azam in copy. This is an activity you will do it as a homework, okay. So you have to paste a picture of a Qaid-e Azam in your notebook, okay. Saudi history, question number 11, fill in the blanks. So number one, filling the blanks is the head of royal family is king. So you will note down this, fill in the blanks in your notebook, okay. The head of royal family is king, is dash is king. The head of royal family is dash, the head of royal family is king, okay. So this is question number 11 of Saudi history subject, okay. Note down this question on your notebook. Home task, exercise A, page number 77 on book. If you didn't complete during the class time, you have to complete it as a homework. And an activity, paste a picture of Qaid-e Azam in copy. And Saudi history, question number 11. You have to note down question number 11 on your notebook. So this is your home task, okay. Any question? This is all about from my side, okay. If you have any question, you can ask in the WhatsApp group. Thank you, dear students. Stay blessed always. Have a nice day. Allah Hafiz.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم Welcome dear students I hope you are fine and happy Dear students as you know it is our Islamic period I am Mrs. Amara Zubair it is our second lecture First, I will tell you about the contents. First, we will take the review of unit number 15, Eid, a Muslim festival. Then, we will do the exercise 1, question A, detailed answer on copy, question B, C, only oral discussion, okay? First, we will take the review, unit number 15, Eid, a Muslim festival. Review. There are two main festivals that Muslims celebrate every year, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. Muslims fast in the month of Ramzan. They celebrate Eid al-Fitr on the first of Shawwal. Muslims fast from before Fajr to Maghrib for 30 days to please Allah. Muslims try to pray and recite the Holy Quran as much as they can in this month. Muslims give their zakat in this month. Muslims offer Tarawih, which is a special Ramzan prayer just after Isha. Eid al-Adha is celebrated after Hajj on the 10th. 11th and 12th of Zilhajj to remember the great sacrifice of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam was ready to sacrifice his son on the order of Allah, but in the end Allah saved him. Muslims sacrifice animals like cows, goats, sheep or camels in the name of Allah on Eid al-Adha in the memory of that event. Muslims offer Eid prayers on the morning of both Eids to thank Allah for all his blessings. Now, dear students, open your notebook. First, you will write the CW date. Then on the first line, you will write the unit number 15, Eid, a Muslim festival, okay? And dear students, you will make margin line, okay? Now we will start our written work, okay? Exercise 1, answer these questions. Question A, when do Muslims celebrate Eid al-Fitr? When do Muslims celebrate Eid al-Fitr? Question A. When, W-H-E-N, when do Muslims, M-U-S-L-I-M-S, Muslims celebrate, C-E-L-E-B-R-A-T-E, celebrate Eid al-Fitr? जी मुसलमान ईद उल फितर कब सेलिब्रेट करते हैं आर स्टूडेंट्स नो अबाउट इट कि मुसलमान कब ईद उल फितर सेलिब्रेट करते हैं सब बच्चों को पता है कि मुसलमान फर्स्ट शवाल को ईद उल फितर सेलिब्रेट करते हैं जब रमजान के रोजे खत्म हो जाते हैं शवाल स्टार्ट होता है तो फर्स्ट शवाल को मुसलमान ईद उल फितर सेलिब्रेट करते हैं आप सब बच्चों को पता है ना तो अब आप इसका आंसर लिखिए अपनी कॉपी पे आंसर मुस्लिम्स सेलिब्रेट ईद उल फितर ऑन द फर्स्ट ऑफ शवाल आंसर ए एन एस आंसर मुस्लिम्स एम यू एस एल आई एम एस मुस्लिम्स सेलिब्रेट C-E-L-E-B-R-A-T-E, celebrate, Eid al-Fitr, E-I-D-E-U-L-F-I-T-R, Eid al-Fitr, on the first of Shawwal, on the first of Shawwal, S-H-A-W-A-L, Shawal. Answer, Muslims celebrate Eid al-Fitr on the first of Shawal. Musalman Eid al-Fitr first Shawal ko celebrate karte hain. Ji, sab bachon ne apna kaam kamal kar liya hoga. Agar kisi bache ne ye question nahi complete kiya, to wo bhi complete kar le. Okay? Now, dear students, it is homework time. You will complete this work, okay? You will write question A on your copy, okay? Jin bachon ne complete kar liya hai, bahut achhi baat hai, lekin jin bachon ka ye kaam complete nahi hua, wo isko as a homework mukammal karenge, okay, beta? Thank you, dear friends, for listening me. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Fi Amanillah.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning everyone. I welcome all of you in computer science class. Today we are gonna start lecture 2 of this week. So my dear students, get ready to attend your computer science class. You have to open book page number 46. Today we are going to continue chapter 9. And the name of chapter is Picture in WordPad. Chapter 9, Picture in WordPad, page number 46. Open quickly page number 46. We will start with the contents. Yes. We will start our today's lecture by recalling our previous topics. Then we are going to start our new topic, that is about pictures in WordPad. And there will be a practical activity about this today's topic, and that is on also related to lab exercise, that is on page number 51. Our today's objective is that today you will be able to learn or able to insert picture in WordPad document. Like at the end of the lesson, you will be able to insert picture in WordPad documents. That is so easy and simple. You can even change the pictures also. So let's start by reviewing our previous topic. So previously we started that in order to make your document look beautiful, you can even insert. Insert means put pictures. Like put pictures. Insert pictures mean put pictures in your document. You can even insert date and time and paint drawing. All of these options are on insert group, and insert group is on home tab, and home tab is always the active tab. Whenever you open WordPad document, home tab is always the active, like it will be on the screen. Whenever you open your WordPad document, the first tab you will be able to see is the home tab is always active, and like their buttons are always in active mode. You can see their buttons and you can perform the formatting by the help of these tabs. Okay, so you can insert pictures, paint drawings, date and time and objects in your WordPad document. Then we also started, yes, that is, this is about the date and time. Like there are so many different list of dates options, like you can choose any one of them, date and time, even the dates in some format. Day is also mentioned. You can even add insert day, date and time in your document, like with the help of this button. So this button, date and time, as the name shows, that name, date and time, you can insert date and time in your document by choosing any one of the format that are available. Just click on date and time option or button and then just choose any of format available and click OK. This is how you're gonna insert date and time. And yes, we also studied about the paint drawings, that is on MS Paint program. So WordPad allows you to insert paint drawings in your document. Like you can even draw your draw anything whatever you want by drawing shapes or use freehand like pencil and make your document look more attractive and beautiful by inserting your own drawings. And even you don't have to just follow the difficult procedure. You just have to click on the paint drawing option that is on home tab in the insert group. Just click on the on that button and your MS Paint program window will appear, as you can see right now on your screen. When you press on this on the paint drawing buttons that is on WordPad, this window will appear, as you can see right now on your screen. This will appear and you can insert, you can draw pictures, you can draw shapes, whatever you want. Then you are just going to close that window. You don't need to save anything, just close that window and then you can see your drawing on the WordPad document. And if you want to make changes, then what you are gonna do, you will just click, double click on the drawing, and then your MS Paint program window will appear again, and you can make any change. If you want to remove something, you can remove it, you can erase it. And if you want to draw more, then you can draw it also. Okay, so that was about the paint drawing. Like, you can insert or put drawings that are created in Windows Paint program. And now it's time for our today's topic, that is also very interesting, that you can even insert your own pictures, your own picture or any other picture that you downloaded from online, downloaded them. Okay, so this picture button, that is also on home tab and insert group. So this buttons, like picture buttons, allow to insert pictures from your computer into your document, like the pictures that are already saved in your document. You can even add those pictures in your WordPad document. And then this button also helps, also has the option to change your picture. Like, when you click on this here, you can see the pictures, the insert group buttons. When you click on this drop down arrow, you can even change the size, change the picture, like change picture with another one. Like, you insert the picture of cat, but you want to insert the picture of dog. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna just click on this. Instead of removing or pressing backspace or just deleting the picture, you can just change. Just click on the change picture. Here you can see a change picture. You can just click on it, then window will appear and choose another picture, and automatically your previous picture will be replaced by the new one. And you can even resize your picture. Like, resize means to increase or decrease the size of your picture, make it bigger or smaller. So in WordPad, you can add pictures that are already saved in your computer. Then you can even change the picture. And finally, like, with the help of this button, you can make your text look beautiful, make more attractive, and it will be interesting. It will look very interesting and beautiful. So this is about our today's picture. Like, that is on home tab, insert group, picture button, right? There is picture button. When you click on picture button, your window will appear like this, as you can see right now on the screen. Then choose any picture, like you want the picture of torch, just click on it and then open. Press on open button and automatically your picture will be on your WordPad document. But if you want to change the picture of torch with the bulb one, then you are just gonna click again on the drop down picture drop down arrow, and instead of picture, then you are going to choose change. Then again, this window will appear, and you can choose the picture. Like, instead of torch, if you want to add bulb, then click on this picture and then open. This is how you are going to make your document look more pleasing or more beautiful. So get ready, because it's time for practice. Now I'm gonna show you how you are going to insert picture in WordPad document. So time for action. So the first step is menu. Click on start menu. Again, type WordPad, and here you can see the WordPad document. Now today I'm gonna open the already saved document. So what is the procedure? What are the steps? Yes, go into the file button, and here you can see the recent documents. Even from here you can open your already saved documents, or from this open button, but this one is more easy. So I'm gonna just click on it. I'm just going to open the file. Yeah, remember, Max loves apples. Apple starts with A, X and ant also starts with A. Yes, this one. we are going to start this, like open this document and make it more beautiful. How? By adding pictures. Yes, now we are gonna add pictures in these, in this document. So here you can see Max loves apples. Apples start with A. So I'm just gonna go like in the first line, just move your cursor and then press enter, because here in this second line I want to add picture of apple. I'm going to go again into the home tab, look at the home tab, insert group and pictures, click on it, click on pictures, and here you can see it will take a little time. It is taking time. Yes, now you can see that a pictures, like here are some other pictures also. There are also folders. I have created these folders. Now what you have to see, you have to just look at the picture, look at this area. It's always, whenever you click on it, the picture folder will open. Now here it's written computer. Now picture is already being saved in this folder, so I am just going to click on apple because I want a picture of apple. Just click on it. Okay, then press open. Now you can see the picture of apple on your WordPad document, right? You can see the picture. Now I want to make it a bit smaller because it is too big. I'm just gonna go again in insert group, and here you can see change picture, change picture, and resize picture. But I don't want to change the picture, I want to resize, make it smaller. So you can even choose from here, like horizontally 70. You can choose like this also, like decrease the size horizontally and vertically also. Decreases by pressing drop down arrows. Okay, now it's get smaller. Or even you can also resize the picture by using your mouse pointer. Just click on the picture and yes, like click on this picture and make it like this. Drag it and it will get smaller. Click on picture, drag, and it will get smaller. So this is about inserting picture. Oops. Undo it again because I was just moving the second line, so it get deleted. So what I've done, just press undo. Yes, this is how you are going to insert picture. Now Sam loves a ball. Ball starts with B. Okay, now time for inserting picture of ball. Press again enter to move into the next line. Again go into the pictures, select picture, and here is a picture of ball. You can insert it like this. Again you can decrease, like make the size of the ball smaller by just dragging it with the help of mouse, or you can even resize it, the picture, like it's right now 100%. Now I'm gonna decrease the size, make it smaller. Just press the drop down arrows like this one, and I want to make it in 50 size. Okay, yes, 50% horizontally and vertically like this. Now you can see the size of picture is smaller. Now I'm gonna just zoom out, so you will look the look at the page like how it looks like this. Max love apples. Now you can see the picture of apple. Then we it is written Sam loves ball. Now the picture of ball is over here. Now I'm just gonna show you how you are going to save pictures, like if you don't have these picture of ball, or then the picture of apple, and there is another picture that is, now I'm gonna move this in the next page. Yes, like this. Okay, now it is written car and loves car. Now I'm gonna insert the picture of car. So listen carefully, if you don't have these pictures, like the picture of ball, car, dove and apple, how you are going to save? You just have to open your Google Chrome. Okay, just open it I'm going to maximize it. So this is how you're gonna okay, this is how it looks. So click on it, and then I'm gonna type over here car clip art. Okay, so now here you can see the pictures, different pictures on your screen. Save any picture, just open the picture, click right on it, and here you can see save image as. Click on it. Now you can see this window will appear, and I'm just going to open computer folder because I want to save this picture over here in the computer folder. So click just save. This is how you are going to download picture and then insert if you don't have in your laptop. Then I want the picture of also dove. Okay, this one. Here you can see the picture of dove. Okay, click any one of it. Click right click and save image. Then just press save. This is how you are going to save or download pictures if you don't have any picture in your laptops or computers. Okay, the Google's job is done. Like, I don't need Google anymore, so I'm gonna just close it. And now this WordPad document, now I am just going to insert the picture of car. So what are the steps how I'm gonna insert picture of car? Yes, press here. Okay, second line, go into the insert group. So where is insert group? Insert group is on home tab. Click on it, picture, and it will just taking a little time. Okay, and then yes, here you can see the picture of car which we saved from, like we have saved right now from by using Google. Okay, here you can see the picture of car, and resize it, make it smaller like this, just drag it. Now the last thing is about Pam loves dove. Dove starts with D. So again, at the end of the sentence, go move your cursor and press enter like this. Again, pictures, drop down arrow, picture, and just click on this picture, picture of dove, and press it like this. This is how you are going to insert pictures one by one. Now our text look more beautiful, right? It looks more beautiful. I'm going to zoom out, so all of the pictures will be visible like this. Here it is written Max love apples. Apple starts with A. Now you can see the picture of apple over here. And then X. Okay, Sam loves ball. Now you can see the picture of ball also, and loves car. Car starts with C, and then Pam loves dove. Dove starts with D. So this is how you can make your text look more beautiful by inserting pictures. Even you can insert your own pictures, like when you click on it, pictures, then you can see here your pictures. In the pictures camera roll, there must be your pictures in your laptops. You can add even those pictures. Okay, so this is how you are gonna add pictures. Let's revise again. Like home tab, on home tab there is a group insert. In the insert you can see pictures. You can just click on it and then choose any picture, and you can see picture on your screens on the document. So that was it. Now more important step, that before closing you have to save. I'm just gonna save it from by just clicking on file and click on save button. You can even save more easily by just pressing Ctrl+S. And this is how you're gonna save your document. That is already, we opened the already saved document, and now we have made changes, and now again save them. Okay, so that was our today's practice. Now what you have to do, you have to do the similar thing, like you have to open already saved document that was about the this one, the Max loves apple. Okay, and insert pictures. If you don't have pictures, you can download from Google, like Right, Apple clip art and then insert the page. Save it. I show you how you are going to save the download or save pictures online. Then you're just gonna insert these pictures and resize pictures. If you think you need to resize them, then you can resize and save and close your document. And don't forget to share on WhatsApp group, okay? Because I will be waiting for your pictures of these like activity. So now it's time for preview. In our upcoming lesson, we are gonna start a new topic, that is in the same chapter number 9, picture in WordPad, page number 47, that is start a list. We will make a list in our upcoming lecture, okay? So get ready. Yeah, there will be also a practical activity about the how to make a list or how to start a list. And now, boys and girls, if you have any question, you can ask in WhatsApp group. And take care of yourself. Thank you for listening. Have a nice weekend. Allah Hafiz.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
हाँ जी बच्चों, मैं आपकी कुरान टीचर मिसेज मकसूदा हूँ. आप सब कैसे हैं? अल्लाह ताला से उम्मीद करती हूँ कि आप लोग सब खैरियत से होंगे और अल्लाह ताला से दुआ करती हूँ कि अल्लाह ताला आपको अपने हिफ्ज़ो अमान में रखे और आपको सेहत वाली, सलामती वाली लंबी जिंदगी अता फरमाए और अल्लाह ताला आपको हर किस्म की रूहानी, जिस्मानी बीमारियों और वबाओं से बचा करके अल्लाह ताला आपकी हिफाजत फरमाए और अल्लाह ताला आपके सीनों और जेनों को खोले, रोशन और मुनव्वर करे और अल्लाह ताला आपको हर इम्तहान में कामयाबियां अता फरमाए. और बेटा, ये ताकीद करती हूँ कि जिस तरह से आपको हरूफ का तलफ्फुज़ सिखाया जा रहा है, जिस तरह हरूफ आपको सिखाए जा रहे हैं, आप उसी तरह इसकी प्रैक्टिस करके उसी तरह याद करें ताकि आपके जहनों में ये सही तलफ्फुज़ जो है, सही अदायगी जो है, वो बैठ जाए. क्योंकि बेटा, अभी आपके सीखने की एज है, इसमें आप जिस तरह सीखेंगे फिर उसी तरह आपके जहन में ये बैठ जाएगा. और बेटा, जो सूरतें आपको याद करवाई जा रही हैं, वो सूरतें अच्छे तरीके से याद करके उनको अपनी नमाज के अंदर पढ़ें ताकि वो हमेशा आपको याद रहें, फिर वो भूलें ना. और बेटा, दुआएं जो आपको सिखाई जा रही हैं, दुआएं सिखाने का मतलब ये है कि क्योंकि नबी करीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम सुबह से लेके शाम तक, फिर शाम से लेके सुबह तक के का सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम का ये मामूल था कि आप सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम हर मौके पर दुआ पढ़ा करते थे, तो आपको भी इसलिए सिखाई जा रही है ताकि आप भी ये सारी दुआएं याद करके अपने दिन और रात को नबी करीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के तरीके के मुताबिक जो है अपना दिन और रात गुजारें. ठीक है, तो इन अपनी दुआओं को अच्छे तरीके से याद करें और फिर जिस जिस वक्त की आपको दुआ याद करवाई जा रही है, आप उस वक्त में उस दुआ को पढ़ें और अपनी जिंदगी में उनको अप्लाई करके अच्छे तरीके से अपना दिन और रात गुजारने की कोशिश करें. चलें, ठीक है, अब हम चलते हैं अपने सबक की तरफ. जी, अब हम पढ़ेंगे इंशाअल्लाहुल अजीज. मेरे प्यारे प्यारे बच्चों, हिफ़्ज में हम सूरत तकासुर पढ़ेंगे और सुबह शाम की दुआ हम अच्छे तरीके से याद करेंगे. लेकिन नाजरा, कुरानी कायदा में आपने खुद से सफा नंबर 26 जो है कुरानी कायदा का, वो आपने अच्छे तरीके से खुद से रिवाइज करना है. ठीक है, उसकी आपने दोहराई करनी है. ठीक है. हाँ जी बेटा, ये आपके सामने खुल चुकी है सूरत तकासुर, जो आज हम हिफ्ज करने वाले हैं. आज हम इसको अच्छे तरीके से हिफ्ज करेंगे, याद करेंगे. ठीक है, वैसे तो अभी तो मैं आपको ऊपर से देख देख के और ऊपर एरो ला ला के आपको याद करवाऊंगी अच्छे तरीके से, लेकिन आपने क्या करना है, फिर आपने खुद से इसको अच्छे तरीके से जबानी याद करना है. जबानी याद करके तो फिर आपने इसको अपनी नमाज के अंदर पढ़ना है. ठीक है, तो चलें अब हम इसको पढ़ना शुरू करते हैं. ये है सूरत तकासुर. ठीक है, सूरत का नाम क्या है? सूरत तकासुर. सबसे पहले हम पढ़ेंगे औजु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतानिर रजीम. सूरत तकासुर मक्किया. सारे बच्चे पढ़ेंगे सूरत तकासुर मक्किया. सूरत تكاثر مكية. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. पढ़ें आप लोग बेटा. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. नजर आ रहा है आपको? بسم الله. ठीक है, खड़ी जबर. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ठीक है, चलें. अल हाकु, अल हाकु मुत्तकासुरु. मुत्तकासुरु सा बोलने आपने, सुरु. अल हाकु मुत्तकासुरु, अल हाकु मुत्तकासुरु. हत्ता, खड़ी जबर है, زرتُ زرتُ مل زرتُ مل حتى زرتُ مل مقابر مقابر حتى زرتُ مل مقابر حتى زرتم المقابر ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر. سارے بچے پڑھ رہے ہیں بیٹا, میں آپ کو پڑھا رہی ہوں, ٹھیک ہے؟ آپ نے میرے ساتھ پڑھنا ہے, میرے پیچھے پڑھنا ہے. یہ میں آپ کے لیے پڑھ رہی ہوں, آپ کے ساتھ پڑھ رہی ہوں, آپ نے میرے پیچھے پیچھے پڑھنا ہے, ٹھیک ہے؟ کلا, الف مدہ ہے تو لمبا کریں گے, کلا سوف سوف کلا سوف تعلمون تعلمون سوف تعلمون كلا سوف تعلمون. پھر ہم رکیں گے, رکنے کا سائن ہے, یہ دیکھیں, كلا سوف تعلمون. یہ ہے بیٹا ثم سا, یہ اس لیے ریڈ ہے کہ آپ نے اس کو سا پڑھنا ہے اور میم پر غنہ کرنا ہے. ثم كلا ثم كلا سوف ثم كلا سوف تعلمون. تعلمون ہے تو تعلمون. ثم كلا سوف تعلمون. پھر ہے بیٹا كلا لو كلا لو تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم ال علم اليقين علم اليقين علم اليقين ہے تو رکنے کی صورت میں ہم پڑھیں گے علم اليقين. كلا لو تعلمون, پڑھیں بیٹا آپ لوگ سب پیچھے, کلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين کلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم لتر را کو پور پڑھنا ہے اس لیے گرین ہے. لا تار ونل جہیم, رکیں گے تو پھر پڑھیں گے جہیم. لا تار ونل جہیم ثم ثم لا تار ون ثم لترونها ها عين اليقين عين اليقين ثم لترونها عين اليقين ثم لتسألن ثم لتسألن يومئذ يومئذ عن النعيم عن النعيم عن النعيم ہے نا تو رکنا ہے تو اس وجہ سے بیٹا ہم پڑھیں گے عن النعيم. ٹھیک ہے بچوں, سمجھ آ گئی ہے؟ یہ اب آپ ایک اور چیز دیکھ لیں, جہاں پہ گرین حرف ہیں یہ سارے حرف ہم نے پر پڑھنے ہیں یعنی موٹے پڑھنے ہیں, جہاں جہاں ریڈ کلر ہے وہاں پر ہم نے غنہ کرنا ہے, ठीक है बेटा, यहाँ पर आपको नजर आ रहा है पूरे सूरत में दो ही कलर हैं, ठीक है, एक रेड है और एक ग्रीन है। तो रेड पर हमने क्या करना है, गुन्ना करना है, और ग्रीन को हमने मोटा पढ़ना है। ठीक है बेटा, समझ आ गई है? अब फिर देखते हैं कैसे पढ़ेंगे। أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم سورة التكاثر مكية پڑھے نا آپ نے، میں اس لیے رکی ہوں کہ آپ بھی پڑھیں۔ سورة التكاثر مكية بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألهاكم تكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لا ترون الجحيم ثم لا ترونها عين اليقين ثم لا تسألن يومئذ عن النعيم يومئذ عن النعيم۔
ٹھیک ہے بیٹا، سب کو سمجھ آگی؟ اسی طریقے سے آپ نے، ہر بچے نے اس کو 10 ٹائم پڑھنا ہے، اپنی پوری فنگرز پر ایک ایک دفعہ پڑھنا ہے، ٹھیک ہے؟ ہر بچہ اس کو 10 ٹائم پڑھے گا، پھر اس کو اچھے طریقے سے اپنی نماز کے اندر بار بار پڑھے گا، تاکہ آپ کو اچھے طریقے سے یاد رہے اور پھر بھولے نہ، ٹھیک ہے؟ ہاں جی بچوں، یہ ہے دعا جو ہم نے صبح و شام پڑھنی ہے 7 دفعہ، ٹھیک ہے؟ یہ صبح و شام کی دعا ہے جسے ہم پڑھیں گے 7 دفعہ، اور یہ دعا بہت ہی فائدہ مند ہے اور بہت ہی بہترین دعا ہے، اور اس کے بارے میں نبی کریم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم فرماتے ہیں کہ جو شخص یہ دعا صبح و شام 7 دفعہ پڑھے، اللہ تعالیٰ اس کے دنیا اور آخرت کے سارے کام درست فرما دیتا ہے، اور اس کے علاوہ بھی اگر کسی انسان کو کوئی مشکل ہو، پریشانی ہو، تو وہ اپنی وہ پریشانی اور مشکل میں اللہ تعالیٰ کو پکارے اور یہ کلمات ادا کرے، تو اللہ تعالیٰ اس کی پریشانی اور مشکل میں اللہ تعالیٰ اس کو کافی ہو جاتا ہے، اللہ یعنی کافی ہو جاتا ہے یعنی اللہ تعالیٰ اس کی مدد کرتا ہے، اللہ تعالیٰ اس کی مشکل اور پریشانی کو اپنے ذمہ لے لیتا ہے۔ ٹھیک ہے بچوں، سمجھ آ گئی ہے؟ آپ کو بھی کبھی مشکل لگے، کوئی پڑھائی مشکل لگے، کوئی ایگزام مشکل لگے، تو آپ پہلے اس دعا کو پڑھ لیں، ٹھیک ہے؟ چلے میں آپ کو پڑھانا سکھاتی ہوں تاکہ آپ کو پتا چلے کہ جب بھی کوئی مشکل یا پریشانی ہو تو ہمیں یہ دعا پڑھنی ہے اور کس طرح سے اس کو پڑھنا ہے۔ چلیں، اور کتنی دفعہ پڑھنی ہے؟ اسے ہم نے 7 ٹائم پڑھنا ہے، صبح کو اور 7 ٹائم شام کو، ٹھیک ہے؟ چلیں اس کو پڑھتے ہیں۔ حسبی اللہ، حسبی اللہ لا الہ، حسبی اللہ لا الہ الا، حسبی اللہ لا الہ الا ہوا، الا ہوا، الا ہوا، حسبی اللہ لا الہ الا ہوا علیہ، الا ہوا علیہ، الا هو عليه، حسبي الله لا اله الا هو عليه، توكلت توكلت توكلت، حسبي الله لا اله الا هو عليه، توكلت حسبي الله لا الہ الا ہوا علیہ توکلت وہو وہو
वाह हुआ, लंबा नहीं करना, वाह हुआ लंबा नहीं करना है, वाह हुआ वाह हुआ। हस्बी अल्लाहु ला इलाहा इल्ला हुआ अलैहि तवक्कलतु वाह हुआ रब्बुल अर्शिल रब्बुल अर्शिल रब्बुल अर्शिल। ठीक है बेटा, रब्बुल अर्शिल, ठीक है। वह हुआ रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम अर्शिल अजीम, वह हुआ रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम, वह हुआ रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम। हस्बी अल्लाहु ला इलाहा इल्ला हुआ अलैहि तवक्कलतु वाहुवा रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम, वाहुवा रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम। हस्बी अल्लाहु, आप लोग सारे पढ़े, सारे बच्चे पढ़े, ठीक है, शाबाश। और जल्दी याद करना है आपने, और आपने फिर सुबह शाम इसको पढ़ना है 7-7 टाइम। अपनी फिंगर पर आप काउंट कर लेना, ठीक है। शाम के वक्त इसको 7 दफा पढ़ना और सुबह के वक्त भी इसको 7 दफा पढ़ना, ठीक है। हस्बी अल्लाहु ला इलाहा इल्ला हुआ अलैहि तवक्कलतु वा हुआ रब्बुल रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम। हस्बी अल्लाहु, मुझे अल्लाह काफी है, ला इलाहा नहीं कोई माबूद सिवा इल्ला हुआ सिवाय उसके, सिवाय उस अल्लाह के हमारा कोई और माबूद नहीं, हमारा कोई और दूसरा अल्लाह नहीं। इल्ला हुआ सिर्फ वही है, अलैहि उसी पर, तवक्कल तू मैंने तवक्कल किया यकीन किया भरोसा किया, वाह हुआ और वो अल्लाह, वाह हुआ और वो अल्लाह जो है, वो जो रब है, वो जो मालिक है, रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम, वो अर्श अजीम का मालिक है, वो अर्श अजीम का रब है, वो रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम, वो अर्श अजीम का मालिक है, ठीक है बच्चो। हस्बी अल्लाहु ला इलाहा इल्ला हुवा अलैहि तवक्कलतु वह हुआ रब्बुल अर्शिल अजीम, ठीक है बेटा। इसी तरह से आपने इसको अच्छे तरीके से याद करना है जी बच्चों। आपने नाजरा कुरान कायदा का सफा नंबर 26 जो है उसको देख के आपने पढ़ना है अपने तौर पे, ठीक है। और सूरत तकाथर को अच्छी तरह से आपने याद करना है, और सुबह शाम की दुआ को भी आपने अच्छी तरह से याद करना है, ठीक है। यही आपका होमवर्क है। हाँ जी मेरे प्यारे प्यारे बच्चों, आप लोगों ने बहुत अच्छे तरीके से पढ़ा और बहुत अच्छे तरीके से सुना, और आप लोग साथ साथ पढ़ते रहे और बहुत अच्छे तरीके से पढ़ने के लिए थैंक यू वेरी मच, जज़ाकुमुल्लाह खैर। हाँ जी बच्चों, नेक्स्ट वीक तक के लिए इजाजत चाहती हूँ। अल्लाह हाफिज, फी अमानिल्लाह, अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू।